Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about execute SQL task. So here we will discuss about the source types and how we can use it. So let's start. So as we have discussed in our last video, we have three type of source. First is direct input, second is file connection, and last is variables. So let's start with direct input. So before going to SSDT to implement the package, let's discuss about the scenario. So as you can see, we have an input table and it doesn't have any data. And by using SSIS package, I want to insert record on it. So go to on SSDT and here I need to add one more package. Then I wish to rename this package with execute SQL task, then source type. Now I need to drag and drop execute SQL task, then double click on this execute SQL task. Then here in SQL statement, as we can see connection types. So here we have many more options. So I gonna use OLADB connection type. Rest will be discussed later on this video series. Then we need to make the connection. So we can click on new connections. As I have already made the connection, so I gonna use that one. Click on OK. Here we have option for direct input. So here I need to write the query. So I have already written the query. So I need to copy this insert statement and then go to on SSDT. Then we need to paste that query. Now click on OK. Then again OK. So we have done our package. Now I gonna execute our package. So package has been executed successfully. So now I gonna stop this package and go to on SSMS, and here I need to check the records. Now we can press Ctrl R. So as we can see, data has been inserted successfully on this table. So this is by using direct input. Second, we have a flat file and it has the SQL queries. So these SQL queries will be executed. Now go to on SSDT and then double click on this execute SQL task. So instead of direct input, we need to select file connection. Then it would ask for file connection. So we can select, then we can browse. I wish to copy this path and this is our file. Now click on open, then OK. Now we have done our file connection. Now click on OK. Now we can save our package and execute. Then in this file we have total 5 rows. So 6 rows should be available in our table. Go to on SSMS. Now we can press Ctrl R. So as we can see, 6 rows. So data have been inserted successfully in this table. So this is by using file connection. Next, we need to create one variable. So we can add one variable and this is for SQL query and data type should be string. And what would be the value? So I gonna copy our insert statement. Then we can paste our insert statement in this value. Now I can close this variable, go to on execute SQL task, and here we need to select variables instead of file connection, and then we need to select our variable name. So our variable name is SQL query. So this is our variable. Now click on OK. So we have done our package. So go to on SSMS. So in this table, I wish to delete all the records which is available in this table. So now we don't have any record on this table. Once I execute this package, so one row should be inserted in our table. Click on start. So package has been executed successfully. Now we can stop this package and go to on SSMS. Now we can press Ctrl R. So as we can see, data has been inserted successfully in our table. So this is from variable. So these are the input types. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.